If you want to learn how to build resilience in business, then this video is definitely for you. It's a short 10-minute training which I produced for my private members group. Apologies for the quality of the video. It's not fantastic. I recorded it through Zoom, but hopefully the content is good and you'll get tons out of it. How we handle these ups and downs, and I kind of alluded to this just before Christmas, or in between Christmas and New Year, sorry, with the video which I did last week about Simon Sinek talking about the infinite games. It's quite relevant now, more so than ever, because of obviously what happened, the announcement here in the UK on Monday and lockdowns. Most people, for some reason, see business as a bit more like a football match. So they see it as like you think about a football or any sports match, it's a finite amount of time, like 90 minutes. The goal is to obviously score goals, and the team who scores the most goals wins. The team who has more goals scored against them loses. If they score the same, it's a draw. At the end of the day, when the game's over, the final whistle goes, we get to decamp, irrespective of win, lose or draw. We get to have a bit of R&R. We go out and do a bit of practice, and then we go back and take on the next game. For some reason, people in business think that it's the same in business, that all of a sudden, miraculously, we're going to go out and score loads of goals and win, and that's it. But the stark reality is that the game is infinite in business. It just, and Simon Sinek's written a great book on this if you want to go and check it out, because this is how we ultimately build up resilience in business. He talked about if you want to get to doing 10K a month, for example, I have a six-figure business or whatever it is. Well, that's great, but what happens after that? Like, it just carries on, and then you hit 10K and then you want to do 20K and it's like, what happens next? So for as long as you carry on running your business, it's this infinite game. And what's going to happen during that infinite game, there's going to be skirmishes. Imagine it's a little bit like a war, a battle. You know, it's probably a bit of a negative analogy, but I can't think of a better one at the moment. Imagine it's a bit like a war. You prepare for battle, you go into battle, you either lose a few troops or you win the battle, but then you retreat, go back, re-energize yourself, and then you have to go back into battle again. The side which ultimately wins or loses from that, if you lose, you kind of just go, do you know what, that's it, we've lost the war, we back out and we don't go back into battle again. And if you think about it in business terms, that's when we just give up. We give up the fight and it's done. There are people out there who just enjoy the battle. They don't give a about whether they get clients or not. They don't give a shit about whether they hit those five-figure months or six-figure years. They just enjoy going in, like preparing for battle, getting dressed up in all the gear for battle. They enjoy the energy and the buzz that they get in battle. They enjoy the buzz and the energy from losing in battle. Like, they just enjoy the whole war. They're almost slightly scary people. I count myself to be one of those people. I don't care kind of what happens. Like, obviously I want to see everybody have great results. That's ultimately what this game is about. If we get knocked, if we take, you know, when things go wrong, if we start to take those things on board personally, especially when they're out of our control. So we have stuff which is in our control, we have stuff which is out of our control. COVID, totally out of our control. Let's be fair. There's nothing we can do to influence that. The only way we could influence it potentially is if we take business out of the picture for a second, is if we go and sort of isolate ourselves on our metaphorical islands. That's the only way we could ultimately protect ourselves from this. But if we want to carry on fighting the war, we've got to face up to that external circumstance that's going on around us and carry on regardless. It's a bit like if we start to give it energy and change the way that we do our business, change our tactics that we take into battle with us. Imagine if we go back into battle with a new tactic that we haven't tried and tested before. How successful do we think that's going to be? So if we end up pivoting too much when things like negative things like now that are going on around us, we open ourselves up to be flanked, you know, for the opposition to come in at our sides because we hadn't thought about it because we've got this new unbattle tested strategy that we're trying to build. Okay. So the worst thing you could do is allow these external circumstances right now to influence your decision making. Turn back to what you know works. Go back to the familiar. Double down on what is familiar, because that will ultimately, it's actually a safe place to be, but you know that it has probably a better chance of working than trying something completely new right now. And as a part of that, the bit which many of you, most of you won't be so familiar with or practiced at it, like I've been in business for 17 years running my own businesses. I had a couple of side hustles and a job before that. So you could argue I've been in business for the best part of two decades. This is the third recession technically that I've run a business through. You learn to just roll with the punches. I don't take it personally when clients, prospective clients or other social media gurus and experts try and, maybe without trying, make my life difficult or say negative things about me or decide that they want to leave or any of those sorts of things. It is just a part of the process. There is no point in giving it power. Okay, there is no point in turning it into a negative emotion and giving it power. Super important to remember. It doesn't serve anybody. It's a bit like, imagine if I was going to jump out of an aeroplane next week. If I spend the next week worrying about it, like I'm going to tell myself all of these stories and stresses and worries and everything else. And actually the reality is, I don't really need to worry about it until I'm 34,000 feet up in the air, strapped to somebody and the door's flung open and I'm about to jump out. That's the only time when really I need myself. Do you get the analogy here? Like for most of us, we might lose our little mini battles, skirmishes that we lose. We might lose the odd client, 100 quid here, 200 quid there, even 500 pounds here or there. Doesn't matter. That's not going to break us. We're not going to lose our houses as a result of those little like skirmishes that we end up losing. But if we give power to that, we're going to end up worrying about it for the next week, the next month, the next year. We're going to take it personally. And what happens is it narrows our focus. I think many of you will have heard me talk about fixed mindset and growth mindset in the past. A growth mindset. So fixed mindset is I can't. We take it personally. I can't. The world is against me. I just keep on losing. I can't. That's when we start to lose the war. That's when we start to just give up and become prisoners. And we don't stand a chance of winning it. A growth mindset is when we turn that around and go, how can I make more money? How can I get my next client? What could I do to turn this around? How could we start to just maybe think about this slightly differently, add another layer of defenses into what we're doing? Like, don't get me wrong, not negating what's going on around us, like right now. It's very hard to, you know, it's impossible to ignore it. A couple of things I want you to do for me over the next few days. I want you to start to tune out from the news. Very basic thing. Check in on the news once a week just to see what's going on in the world. But you don't need to check in every day. You don't need to watch the 9 o'clock news to get all the latest updates. We know where we're at now, okay? So start to switch off from the, because that's an external circumstance or thing that we can't control. So let's just switch it off and start to ignore it. Do you know what I did this week? Switched a load of notifications off that were popping up on my phone. New apps that I'd signed up to over the last few weeks, months. Just turn the notifications off. Too much noise at the moment. Do you know what else I did? I went into my diary and I graded all of my appointments for this week on a scale of 1 to 10. 10 being the highest level of anxiety I was getting when I looked at like gut instincts and I looked at that thing in my diary. How anxious does it make me feel? If I felt it was going to add to my workload, if it was like above a 6 or a 7, I cancelled it. So I removed several things from my diary this week that were just not important, just making me anxious. Maybe they were important, but it was just too stressful. Okay, so the things you know which trigger you, now is the time to start switching them off. News is one of them, appointments, notifications, and things like that. It's a process of just simplifying life so you can give attention now to the things which are most important. Again, this is reiterating a lot of stuff which you already know through being in Fearless as well. Marketing, right? We always talk about, and I'm probably going to sound like a broken record, assets versus activity. We can get so tied up doing marketing activity on a daily basis that doesn't necessarily produce immediate results, and it can erode any kind of positive kind of momentum and enthusiasm and things like that, because we put all this time and energy into marketing activities, but we don't necessarily get the results like immediately from it. Might get a few likes and things like that, but we don't necessarily get the clients. Assets are different. You can bury yourself, treat it like a hobby, bury yourself in building marketing assets that are going to stand the test of time. Books, YouTube channel. Remember the BHAGs we talked about, you know, during the last coaching session, plan for 2021, building out these big, hairy, audacious goals. They're marketing assets. YouTube channels, books, you know, blog articles, Google My Business, getting tons of reviews, writing up case studies for like client success stories, things like that. They're all going to be there ad infinitum. So, you know, if you stop doing the marketing activity and you stop spending money on Facebook ads or any kind of advertising for that matter, these assets are still going to be there sweating away for you. This is about realizing, so in the infinite game, the difference there is with marketing activity, we want the immediate result. We want the satisfaction of going into battle and winning that one battle. Building assets is like arming ourselves for the war, the long-term war that we know that we're going to face, multiple battles.